Are you safe at Southwest Florida International Airport?
The airport's own police officers are handing out flyers to passengers, raising that very question. Last year, an NBC2 investigation revealed the police department's history of favoritism and discrimination. It's run by the Port Authority. Well, now officers claim the Port Authority is breaking the law and not paying them for their work.
NBC2's Daily D'Ambra is live in our studio with an update to a story you will only see on NBC2.
Hundreds of these flyers have gone out to travelers. They say the Port Authority is denying some police officers raises because they are now with a police union. And the Port Authority admits to that. A state agency that regulates labor law says that practice is unfair. And here's where your safety comes in. They say the longer this goes on, officers will want to quit. And with fewer police, your safety could be in jeopardy.
Want to read a flyer on airport safety? From the police officers. Thank you.
A simple message.
See our flyer about airport safety?
Teamsters Local 79 bargaining agent John Schultes is trying to get that message out.
From the police department?
The paperwork suggests police officers on the ground at the airport don't feel motivated to work.
It's become a tense working environment.
Thank you.
Schultes used to have officers by his side passing out the flyers.
Some of the police officers were called in the office and faced with a very intimidating meeting from the police chief. In no uncertain terms, they were told to stop handling. They feel that their jobs ultimately are at risk, that they have a target on their back for participating in passing out flyers, which is their legal right to do.
The Port Authority is denying raises because officers have not reached a union contract yet. The Florida Public Employees Relations Commission ruled that could be against the law.
It makes a big impact.
Passengers at the airport think low morale in the police force will lead to high turnover.
And you have to constantly be training in officers.
And fewer officers would mean fewer eyes to spot danger in the terminal.
It jeopardizes the safety of travelers.
There is a concern for safety when these officers' minds are not 100% on their game because they're concerned about retaliation from their employer.
Other passengers disagree.
They are not doing their job if they didn't come to work and protect people, just like whether they got a raise or not.
The state is investigating the charge of unlawful labor practices by the Lee County Port Authority against its police officers. For now, some of those officers could be losing thousands of dollars. Live in the studio, Delia D'Ambra, NBC2.
Lighting up the night for kids inside Golisano Children's Hospital. First responders from 5 different counties all coming together for the great cause. They say it's cold outside, but the look on the faces of the patients certainly worth it.
They're so excited whenever they see all these engines, and you know, sometimes they're really intimidating whenever you're standing right next to them, but them looking down from the hospital, they're gonna look a little bit smaller and a little bit more approachable.
EMS, fire, and police from Lee, Collier, Charlotte, Hendry, and Glades counties all took part tonight.